Hey everybody, I'm Jamie Previance, and I want to introduce you to a revelation. Barbecued ribs in an hour and 15 minutes. If you don't think about barbecue, you know it takes a long time, typically. Baby back ribs, usually you're looking at 3 to 4 hours. Once again, I'm going to show you how to do it in an hour and 15 minutes. Every bit is tender, beautifully seasoned, nice and smoky, really missing nothing except about an hour and a half of your time. First thing, as with any kind of barbecued rib, is to peel the rib. Now, I like to use just a dull dinner knife and get underneath this membrane. Can you see the membrane that runs along the bone side here? It's really tough, and it doesn't allow the seasonings or the smoke or the sauce to get in there. So you want to just pry it loose from the back of the bone. And once you've got a little bit of it exposed, you want to grab it with a little towel or something, because it's slippery. And you're basically just peeling it off, almost like it's packaging tape. It's very tough and chewy. You want that out of the way. Now, I've got a spice rub here. You could use any spice rub you want. Make your own, buy some bottled spice rub. This one happens to have some kosher salt, black pepper, some dried thyme, granulated garlic, and some paprika. Really nice mixture of flavors. Just spread that over the meat, rub it in, as the name implies, on both sides, because you eat both sides. And then what I'm going to do, the real magic in this recipe, is cooking the ribs in foil, at least initially. And why that's such a great idea for speeding things up is that as the ribs get hot and the fat begins to render and the juices begin to flow, they turn into this hot steam, which is able to cook the ribs more quickly than the dry heat of a grill or a smoker. And in order to do this properly, we need some heavy-duty foil and a fair amount of it, because you don't want fat dripping directly into the grill, because we're cooking over direct heat. Typically, ribs are done over indirect heat, right, where the fire's off to the side and the ribs are cooked over no heat at all. In this case, in order to speed things up, we're actually cooking over direct heat. And if the fat and the juice were to fall in there, they would very likely flare up. So it's a good idea to actually double wrap each one. And when you're handling these packages, be careful not to poke into them with your tongs or something else. Otherwise, you might create a hole that will allow the fat and the juice to drip into the fire. So what we're going to do is put them over direct medium heat and let them cook for about an hour. And then take them off of the grill, take a look at them, and I think you will be amazed at how tender they look, how well cooked they are. But they're not going to have that beautifully browned, caramelized quality about them. They're just basically going to be steamed. So I got a couple of nice packages here and a couple that I've done up ahead of time. I'm just going to put everything right over direct medium heat. Let it start bubbling away. I'll come back and take a look in about an hour. So it's been about an hour. I'm going to check to see if they're done. I know what you're thinking. How could they possibly be done? Ribs take 3 or 4 hours, right? Well, let's have a look. Now, the way that you know that they're done is by how much bone is sticking out above the meat, because the meat shrinks back from the ends of the bone as it cooks. And you're looking for about a quarter of an inch to maybe a half an inch of shrinking back from the bone. And these are looking good. If I just pick it up with my tongs, you can see the bone sticking out there. That's a sign that these are really nice and tender. So what I want to do is now begin to sauce them. And I'm also going to smoke them at this point, so we're going to be adding additional layers of flavor. Wouldn't want to put the sauce on too early because it would burn inside that foil. But now is the perfect time. And I'm going to set them back over direct medium heat, just until this sauce cooks into the meat a little bit and begins to brown and it gets a little bit crispy on the outside. And I'm also going to add the wood smoke at this point. I should take the other ribs off. Just set them aside for the moment. And then this grill has a smoker box. So this metal box here opens up to hold the wood chips. It has a dedicated burner, so you can control actually how hot it is and how much smoke you get, how quickly. Let me just grab a couple of handfuls or tongs full of soaked wood chips. And this is gonna give it that really authentic barbecue flavor. It's not gonna be as smoky as ribs that have cooked, you know, over wood for hours and hours, but it's gonna have a sense of that beautiful aromatic smoke. I'll just show you with this one. You just put it right over direct heat and let it go for about 5 or 10 minutes, just turning it once. So here's how they look after about 5 minutes. You can see nicely browned, darker, even more tender. I mean, you know, if you've got 4 or 5 hours and you want to spend it on an afternoon making ribs, go for it. You're going to have some fabulous results. But if you've got like 2 hours, you know, people are coming over and you want ribs on the fly, this is the way to make ribs. Well-seasoned, sweet, spicy, little bit of smoky. It's everything a rib should be. In fact, it's a revelation.